So you must have found this video because you were trying to add a checkbox or drop-down list to Google Sheets. Let's step through how we got to this point here, which is we have three cells. All of them have the same drop-downs, and they are all a selection of three different directions. First, you start by highlighting the area that you want to put the checkboxes into. Since these are already done, we're going to go right below. Let's go right to the right here. And go to data validation, which may have been your first problem because there's no place that says drop-down box. And in the data validation, this is your cell range. That's what we just highlighted, so you don't have to type anything into there if you highlighted it already. And then the criteria is just the values that you want to see in the drop-down box. Now, if there's a lot of them, this wants you to put them into the spreadsheet and then select them as a range. But we're just going to type them right into here. It's a little bit easier that way. So we'll just say, hey, we're going to give you a list of items and then type in what we're going to do. If you notice there, I'm just typing them right in. There's no quotes and there's no spaces, but there is a comma between each one. And then the magic here, it's already checked for you, but you want to show them in a dropdown. There's other things that this data validation can do, but we're just using it for a dropdown. Once you've done that, leave all the other things here the way they are. They're not really that relevant if you're just doing a checkbox. So we're going to save it and go back to these cells. To activate the checkbox, you have to hover over the down arrow and then left click on it. And here are your different values. So you actually, I'd like to think of it that you have four values here. You have east, west, south, and then you also have just leaving it blank. So let's select east. But if you want to really have a blank there that's a bit more intuitive, go back to data validation. Your values are still going to be in here. And if you do that and the user comes in here, the user can just do select one first if they're not sure. You'd think that would be first, but oh, there it goes. Now it's sorted, right? So they can do one of the three or we're leaving it blank. So that's basically all that you do for a drop-down list. The user can go in here and select from these different values and then they're done. The next option that we're going to go through is a checkbox. This is what we're going to build now. You had employees and you were telling us which region they were from, and you'd like to be able to just put a check next to the one that's right. So this one we'll do a backspace in. If you want to build this, it's a little bit different and it is a little bit of a workaround. So you'll see it works. It's not the greatest, but it does work. Select the area that you want this in. We're just going to build what we have here right below. And again, we're going to do data validation. But here, you're going to build a list of items again, but you're just going to put a check mark in here. So I already have Google Docs up, and I have these symbols. You get these symbols by doing insert special characters. And here you can choose from different symbols. So I have what you would see in a typical radio box, I call them. So a radio box is designed where, say, there's three of them, you can only select one at a time. They're not going to work that way if you do here, but you can have a symbol that looks like that, and you can either put it in there or not. You can have an empty box, a box with a check mark in it. So let's do these. This way you have two options. You have one that's empty, one that's not. So copy them from Google Docs. I just right-clicked and copied. Go back to Google Sheets. Right-click, paste, and then you do want a comma in between them because that's what tells Sheets that they're two different values. And now save this, and you'll have checkboxes. So now I don't want that, I don't want that, but I do want this one. So these, I mean, they definitely visually work, and you can tell that you selected this one, you said no to these. They're not going to work really well when you want to sort things by what you said yes to. Right, or if you want to run a report on it, but certainly if you just have an easy list and you want someone to be able to tell you which are three different directions and you want a checkbox, this will work. This will work just fine. So those are your two basic ways to let a user easily pick something. Do a drop-down list, or you can have this as a checkbox, or you can have it as a little radio box. So that's, I found that by doing radio. I don't think you want this one. And you just click it, it'll add it to your Google Doc. You can add it to your Google Doc. I would imagine the circle's gonna be the no. So click one that looks somewhat similar in size. Put it right next to it. That one's not the right color. Let's try these. Yeah. Insert. Special character circle. So use, I just use the one that says 2B55. Close this. And you want to select that circle. Let's get the data validation menu back up. You want the circle. And you want the circle with a circle, which is the like a selected radio box. And those can be your two options. And save. Then these will look like radio boxes, on or off. Now keep in mind, these, if you see them on the web, their point is that you can only select one. But here you can do as many as you want, so they don't really work like a radio box. Yeah, but you can make it look like it. And if you saw back there for a second, it was giving us an error because it still had the checkbox in, and that's not a character that we allowed.